I haven't physically seen them. I don't know if Ryan's seen them in the Coralville store. But my understanding is there's very little usage to them. And the one usage on one machine, he is replacing the cable on one of them. So it would be completely back to new.
And the reason, just to kind of clarify, the reason Todd says he can't get rid of them, they went to a three-station set that is substantially more money in lieu of these due to space. So while they fit their space, it does fit ours. So there's nothing that's physically wrong with them. It's, they chose a different piece of equipment.
The piece of equipment they're talking about would fit in the middle of this right here and have three different machines where these are individual machines and take a little bit more room up. I don't know if Ryan gave you your pictures of the rooms, if there's any questions. The one that says Kalona Cardio, that is the proposed room. That room would have to have some drywalling stuff. Mike's looked at, that's included on that front page, the 750 to finish out the drywall.
The sheetrock is up with the first coat of mud.
Right.
It'd just be finishing.
Just texturing and putting the electrical drops in and different things like that. That's that second vision with the four treadmills. Actually, mine still has the treadmills facing the wrong way, but yours are correct, huh? Yeah, so. But most of the equipment you see there is right now already in the exercise room. It would just be moved from the existing room into this room. And like I said, there's three windows on that, this side here. So right here, there's three windows to the east, so it would be better lighting, a little more, user-friendly, I guess. So, are there any other questions on, and the weight room shows existing equipment that is there right now, except for the addition of the leg extension leg curl.
It does have that on there.
It has it on, yeah, that's the only, but everything else is up there right now.
The two and the three-year plan have,
down the road wish list.
Yeah, a replacement of an older treadmill, in addition to a recumbent bike, which this, the one fault to this plan, this drawing you're seeing is it's not necessarily the scale. We threw this in a little bit late on this other room. We've measured it off up there and feel comfortable with where we're at.
Those treadmills wouldn't look like they're right on top of each other like they are. There would be a little more space in between them for.
And then we get more into the comprehensive plan of equipment replacement on the schedule and additions too.
Right.
So while year one looks very aggressive, year two and year three look substantially less.
But our also thoughts was to try and get this out of that rec budget funds, there was 11,047 now, the revised number. And go with that initially so that by hopefully the first week in December or so, we could do some open house and some membership push, but we want to have it ready and done. We can't take them up into a room and say, well, this is what we're thinking of doing. We'd rather jump in, use some of that money, and get the existing things taken care of and started as soon as possible.
We'd also look to shore up. Currently, we have 89 members at the ranks.
Right, 90 with 90. The last one we got this week.
Some of the goals for Todd would be to help increase that membership, increase usage,
or 30, yeah.
Increase the 24/7 aspect of it, and promote that, as well as shore up our key list, shore up the responsibility of the key holder, and make sure that's a little more contractually there as opposed to what it is now.
Right.
So we can hopefully move towards a keyless badge system, but for the time being, make sure.
And the other reason we're looking right here towards this time of year is the rec center membership list and stuff that I gave Ryan earlier when we were going through the numbers. November, December, January, February are your big years for memberships. That's the time of year people are buying them. People are, whether they use them the whole 12 months, that's questionable on a consistent basis, but you're four-month holiday area until about February, March are big times when people are buying memberships. So our goal is to get this ready, prepared, and do some open houses, walk some people through, and hopefully increase our membership at the rec center and get it looking a little more user-friendly and member-friendly. So.
Kind of a cabin fever membership drive?
Yeah. Well, our sign-ins every day, January, February, are two pages a day on a 25-page or, you know, a 25-sign-in list. So sometimes you're getting 40, 50 in a day during the first couple months of the year. Then August, September, that time, you're back down here 12, 15, but your regular members are still coming in. So we're trying to draw more regular members into our base, which is 90 right now.
And here's the entry and the security cameras that you're looking at the first of next year?
I'd say that we target making sure that we shore up our racquetball courts. We've got other companies that are costing the keyless entry and the cameras. That's based on one cost right there. That's our first one.
And our also thought was to get that membership a little bigger. It's right now we have, what, 16 keys? 17
14 that are users.
That are like after-hour users.
It's a little tough to justify that cost on 14 users right now, but I think as we can increase our membership 20,
and show it a little more like 24,000.
We can bring that in and it makes a little more sense. Okay. I think that's the future. I mean, that's the vision we all have.
That's why we aren't really including it right now, to look into it a little more.
That's a pretty aggressive program that scheduled there, but I think we can do it.
Yeah, just to reiterate, they did run this by Claudine and I on the recreation committee, and we're 100% for it.
Okay, the agenda reads that the discussion on rec center exercise and weight room. Are we asking for a decision tonight for giving to go ahead?
Yes, I would be. I mean, I think that's the way it was proposed once we met with the park people, or the rec board, so Steve and Claudine.
We're going to discuss it, and if somebody wants to make motion for Todd to go ahead with this.
Yeah, I would move that you go ahead with it.
Okay. One second. And that's the first portion of this.
$11,000
and 40,000.
Yes, be paid out of the recreation funds. Yeah.
Right. Okay. So Steve before I made a motion to go give Todd to go ahead on the first half of this page. Is there a second?
I second
by Kemp. Any further discussion?
This is all done by second line.
The exercise equipment and the flooring part will, the finished sheet rock, trim, and paint will be done by Mike. And is that what you're
saying? No, sheet rock, no. Maybe the trim.
You kind of gave us the estimate of it, correct?
We've got some local people there.
I see you're putting two television TVs in it.
Yes. One would probably go to, depending on how things work, one will probably go down into the actual lounge room downstairs, which is the new carpet.
Radio Shack's going to come in, and Kalona Cooperative Telephone Company's offered to come in and help us with the setup of that. They're very discounted rate, so those will be local.
Are they going to be secured?
Wall mounts, and then they'll be locked to the wall mounts.
And the controls for them?
They'll be on the machines down, or they can check them out of the rec room. Right now, the remotes we have for the TV that's in the exercise room, which Kalona Telephone put in a few years back, just sets on the treadmills and the people as they come in use them. But we can hand those out through the supervisor's office if need be, since they probably won't be able to license their TV and everything. That's something we could check out and they could put back in when they're done.
So you're going to take the TV.